Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Akabane101, and welcome to Warhammer 40,000 Dawn of War Dark Crusade. This is part 9 in our series. As in the last episode, we did take on the orcs twice in a row. We actually claimed the forward base, and what is this place called? The Janus Savannah, which is actually one of my favorite multiplayer maps in the game, so we had no problems taking on the orcs there. Very happy about our win taking on forward base, which now will allow us to, do forward structures. We'll be able to create structures right off the bat, including power nodes, barracks, and armories. That's going to help us out a lot in the coming assaults here. So now we're going to want to go get the Defiler. I'm a bit worried about this. The Necrons usually are pretty strong when it comes to having giant forces that can handle your small troops. In particular, the Flayed Ones are very, very good at handling your smaller units, like just regular old Chaos Space Marines, which will definitely hurt us in the long run. So I'm hoping that we can take them on. We could decide to go and get a Raptor Champion. We could decide to go and get Bulwark, which in fact I kind of want to go get Bulwark because this might actually be an easier attack now that we know where the orcs are actually spawning. However, oh my god, they have a looted tank. They have a looted tank. That is, if no one knows what a looted tank is, it's literally a Lehman Russ tank, only slightly worse and a little bit less accurate, but it's still extremely deadly. And we are going to be dealing with the orcs here on all fronts. That's really bad. But I really want Bulwark because this is going to help us out a lot when it comes to doing forward barracks. Ah, shit. This is a difficult decision. Indeed. I'm gonna do it. What we're gonna do, we're also gonna send in a barracks, and we're gonna get some turrets, we're gonna get some power, we're gonna get an armory. Nah, let's not get the armory. That'll be later on. So let's get power. That'll help us out a lot. That'll basically allow us to get the armory right at the start. So we got one little power node. We have a barracks, obviously, two turrets to defend us, and I think that'll help us out a lot in this attack. We'll grab one more honor guard. As you can see, it's really cheap to build buildings before you go in. So let's go in. Remember, it's a blitzkrieg tactic, so we gotta make sure that we build a lot of units very quickly, and we push out very quickly. That is what we need to do. We know where the orcs are. They're on the far left side of the map, the far west, and they're at the very southern side of the map, I believe. If I can remember this map correctly. Okay, so let's get on moving. Make sure we start getting some Chaos Space Marines out here on the map. Boom. We want to make the armory. There you go. Lovely. Let's move our troops out. This is going to be very important here. This is going to be very crucial to our victory. Don't need that many Chaos Space Marine squads, though. We'll get a couple of heretics out here. Maybe a couple of cultists. Get them ready to go. The cultists will be gathering things as we... as we move out here. There we go. Get our Chaos Space Marine squads ready to go. Before we move out, we'll grab two more points before we decide to do a huge assault on the orc guys here. And we need to remember, they're at the very southern part of the map right here, and their very west side of the map. So hopefully we can kill at least one orc army before we move on out. So we got our corn guy ready to go. We got some cultist squads ready to go here. These guys will be capturing points in the background. Beautiful. Get another Chaos Space Marine squad ready to go. We're able to finally build some leaders. This is going to help us out a lot. Great. Okay, so let's get everyone ready to go. Everyone, move on down. Move on down. Get this other Chaos Space Marine squad here. Nice. Okay, so this is how it's going to go. We're going to destroy one base as fast as we can. The turrets in our base should hold them off for hopefully long enough. And we'll move our heretics out to do some listening post building. Hopefully he doesn't die horribly in his adventures. Alright, here's their attack already. They already have the looted tank in our base. But right now we are pushing the assault. We might want to upgrade these when we can. The turrets will definitely help us out here in the long run. Alright. What can we do here? We got raptors. Unfortunately, the raptors can't... Okay, let's cancel this. Let's delete this. Cool.
We're here for the dark gods. I tried to do your will.
And let's send them out to the southern side of the map. They are assaulting us pretty hard here. A little bit worried about it. A little bit.
great ones are in the area.
Wow, look at them all. Hopefully this little assault here will allow us to stop half of them, if we can.
Of course, we do your bidding.
Move on in, guys. Keep on moving, keep on moving, keep on moving. And let's go kill the settlement. Move, guys, move. There you go. Alright, this is gonna hurt us a lot. Let's move this heretic out if we can. Hopefully he doesn't die. If the heretic can survive, this will help us out a lot because we can get another HQ if we can. Just keep on attacking, guys. Let's get those nice little things going on here. Almost dead. Nice. Alright, cool. Move on to the next base. That's one base down. Did our heretic get out? I don't believe so. I'm just going to keep sending heretics out of our base. Oh, nice. We do have a heretic, though. He will go down south, then. Because we're just going to build an HQ somewhere else, like a bunch of cheesy pansies. That's what we are going to be, man. I like it. How much does it take? Perfect. Go build down here. Gorgeous. This is gonna be great. Alright, we're gonna win this in the most cheesy fashion ever. It's gonna be... wow, okay. Keep on going, guys. Keep on going. I'm surprised how fast they are, by the way. It's kinda funny. Alright, keep on regenerating. Get all your stuff. Good job, guys. You guys are wonderful. Keep on gathering more points, please. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Straight into their base. Straight into their base. Also, this squad is a bit too spread out, to be honest. Alright, I think we should just kill this this Raptor squad. No. This actually... can we kill them? Let's kill them. Come on, guys. There you go. Kill that Slugga Boy squad. There you go, run into the base. Now we don't have to worry about them murdering us. About to lose our HQ, but it's going to take them a little bit of time. If you could speed that up, that would be great. And there you go, go kill this base here. The Blitzkrieg tactic, ladies and gentlemen, the Blitzkrieg tactic. It's totally cheesy, it's totally horrible, but it's the way of the game, and I want this point. I want it good. Yes, everyone go in, please. Even if you... I'm pretty sure we're going to lose a couple Honor Guard here. I don't care. Come on. Once that HQ is dead, we win. And there you go. That's how you Blitzkrieg, guys. That's how you Blitzkrieg. The cheesiest victory I have ever done. I am a little bit hurt by it, but I kind of find it kind of funny. And now we have every single hero power in the map. Look at one defense. One defense. Oh, man. The orcs are so pissed. Look at that. I think they lost their looted tank as well. We must have destroyed it somehow. Not entirely sure how we did that, but okay. That's great for us. No looted tank for them. Did we lose any Honor Guard in this fight? I think we did. We lost one Raptor champion that might have been chilling in our base, so we sent him to his death by accident. It does so happen, but look at those beautiful abilities down at the bottom of the map. That's going to help us out a lot. Now, we could try and push the Orc war boss back into his own stronghold. Or we could go and try and get the Defiler. I think the Defiler would be pretty good. It would also allow us to get a few spots here. Because we'll be defending the Hyperion Peaks. We'll be defending the Janus Savannah. And we'll be defending the Spaceport. Which will be quite nice. Ooh. Ooh. I'm liking it. This is a great, great, great game going on here. Okay, so let's go for the attack. Oh man, I'm so excited. Let's get the barracks, our forward barracks, and let's get a couple of turrets. Let's get a power node. I don't think we actually need to be doing this, but we're gonna have requisition. We're gonna have enough requisition for either attacking the Tau or the Necrons next turn if we have to. So I think we should be perfectly fine here. And also, we want the Defiler. So let's see here. The enemy commander is a hardened veteran. The enemy force likely includes elite infantry. The enemy has two large bases. So will we cheese it? Will we cheese it? I think so. Most likely, because I really like cheesing it right now. It's a lot easier than, dying horribly after like a 10-hour long battle.
Enemy for the great
Okay, so we'll go quickly build that armory. Let's get some Chaos Space Marines out here. Send our Raptor Champion out. We need to find out where the enemy is, so we'll go send him up to these two spots. Send our Raptor Champion out so we can go and do some scouting. Alright, let's get some heretics out in the field. Maybe some cultists. Lovely. Alright, sir. Mr. Chosen Champion. Go grab these delicious points for us, please. There we go. So we found the Necrons. I believe they just spawned here. Let's see what they have. They have nothing. Alright, let's get out of here. Nice. Good job, guys. Alright, sir, just jump on out there. But he will not be doing any combat. He's just going to head back to base because he'll be an obvious casualty in this war. We'll send our cultists around the map to grab whatever they can. Nice. Okay. Good job, guys. Grab these listening posts because we're going to be going on the assault in just a moment here. There we go. Nice. I do dig having all this, all these resources too, right at the start. Get our cultist squad in there as well. I don't think we need a lot of capturing going on. Eliphas, you can go join the cultist squad. A few more troops. Nice. Good job, Mr. Korn Berserker. And I think we're about good to go out on the assault. Get another Chaos Space Marine squad out there. Yes, this Raptor will be chilling out. No, no, no. I did not mean to select that squad. I meant to build a listening post. And build a listening post. In fact, after this heretic is done building his listening post, go on over to those cultists and hang out with those buddies. Okay. This is looking good. Let's grab everyone. Including this squad. Nice. Get the leader. Go for the auto-reinforce. And let's head on out. Let's head on out. Obviously a risky maneuver to move out so quickly, but we have a lot of hero units that are going to allow us to do some serious damage here, which I'm definitely liking. And they don't have too much defenses here. They have three turrets. That's not going to defend them too much. Upgrade to some power swords. Good. Everyone has leaders. Let's go focus fire these turrets down because those will be doing the most damage. There you go. Now, rays do a lot of damage, so let's go. Yeah, I just said do, by the way. The rays do a lot of damage. So we'll definitely handle them in just a moment here. Our banner's doing work, making them all feel fear. Turrets are down. We can just control A the rest of this fight. Now, there is another base, but once we destroy this one, we should be halfway to victory, so that would be great. Get another Chaos Space Marine squad out here. Definitely don't want to hold back here when it comes to building up our forces. Get another heretic ready to go. I'm going to make him build that forward listening whatever post. The post of whatever. I can't remember things too well today. I don't know what's going on, man. I'm recording this episode like right after the previous, and my brain is just farting all over the place. Okay, can we just destroy this HQ? I'd rather not worry about this stupid Necron Lord that's blinding us right now. Alright, and then we'll find out if this Necron Lord does indeed disappear. Does he do the Houdini? Does he do the magic trick? Also, you guys are just being dumb. There you go. Good job, guys. Kill this thing off. Beautiful. And there goes one base. Oh, nope, they cheesed it. They went for another monolith. Go get that down. Those monsters. You see them doing that, too. I'm watching them build another one right off the bat, right when I do this. Come on, get them. Yeah, there we go. Does that wipe them out? Does that wipe them out? Come on, kill these scarabs. What is going on? They're not dead. Oh, there we go. It took them a while. It took them a while to disappear, but we got them. And then the other base should be on the opposite side there. Alright, we're going to regroup with another Chaos Space Marine squad. Make sure everyone is nice and rejuvenated. Repopulated, all that stuff. The Chaos Woman. Speak clearly now, indeed. Alright, go here. Do the damage. I kind of wonder, do Chaos Space Marines know how to make Chaos Armor? Or Power Armor? I would assume they know.
Otherwise, I think they would steal them from Space Marines. I guess power armor, they don't make it anymore. They just kind of have it, don't they? I don't know. They're kind of like a relic. I'm sure anyone that knows the lore of the game would be able to tell me. But I'm quite curious. Quite curious indeed. How the armor works in this game. There we go, there's another turret. Go move out there. Oh, look at them being all cute. Being all cute. I do want to upgrade it to tier 2, though. Let's get some heretics out here. Cultist squad, move out, please. Capture whatever you can. I like how there's this whole southern side of the base. It's very clearly for an army to spawn. But they don't use it for this map, so it's just all for us. It's basically our expansion, if you will. Okay, so that turret's done. All the Necrons are completely terrified. Once these Necron warriors are dead, we'll just focus fire this turret here. I didn't even see that turret. And this chosen champion will need to leave. Yes. There we go. Everyone here is control one. Oh, kill the flayed ones. Before you guys are completely terrified. Look at their morale just slowly going down. Oh, there you go. Nice. Good job, everyone. Kill that Necron Lord off. He's basically dead anyway. And there you go. Hopefully we get a tier 2 before this is over. Nice. Looking good. Did we not get a heretic? Oh, right, because we're going to tier 2. Of course. Whatever of course. How could I forget?
As you wish.
Build that listening post. Ah, well, it's probably not going to be done in time, but... Hey, we did a good job. We got our Defiler. This Blitzkrieg tactic nonsense is helping us out a lot. Rushing them right at the start with all our hero guys is great. Yeah, Space Marines will make up for all the lack of range damage. There you go. I like it. I don't think we lost any hero units either because I was careful enough to pay attention to their health bars. Which I'm not particularly someone that does that. Look at them making another building there. Yep, you guys are dead. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, but it's true. It's over. Kill the scarabs so they can't keep spawning more buildings. Alright, there you go. There you go. As cheesy as it is, it's working for us, and I like it. There we go. 415 conquests. I have a feeling that this is how you beat hard mode. So melt a gun. How much damage did we get to? We get 383. Obviously, that's a lot of range damage, but he's in melee combat a lot more, so we're just going to go for the Man Reaper for now. So we got the 15 conquests ability, which is great. I don't know how else you can check like what the achievements are. Let's go to the war gear. Does it tell us? Does it tell us how we earn these points? No, I don't think so. Oh, well. We'll figure it out. Next time we earn war gear, I'll make sure to do that. I think we just need to do a few more defenses. Okay. So the tower moving out towards the orcs. They fail. Okay. I was kind of hoping they won, but... Oh, my God. I would totally auto-resolve if our strength wasn't 5 to their strength of 11, because this is how it's factored in. So, technically, this area is a very difficult place to defend, even though we have a very easy time defending it. And also, we just want to do actual defenses, because once we do 5, which I think this is our 5th one, then we get another piece of war gear, one step closer to becoming the Demon Prince. Alright. Let's move on out here. We got some corn guys ready to go. 2 squads of corn would be great. And then maybe some Chaos Space Marines to top it off. Can we get some Defilers out here? I think we can get one in just a moment. Boom, there we go. And we want some Possessed Marines. I think we should probably make an HQ here. I would like to make a second HQ for this area just so we can have a little bit of extra power. That would probably help us out a lot. But for now, I guess our best bet is to upgrade our power nodes. Oh, we already have that going on. Apparently, I was very quick on the ball with that because I must have... Yeah, I must have really wanted it. There you go. Alright, let's get our demon obliterator kin, whatever they're called. I don't even know. I don't even know, man. I like how it's 5 power to reinforce a Khorne Berserker squad. Just because it wants to use power. Just because. It's not a lot of power. It just wants to use it. But I guess it's a lot if you don't have any power nodes, so... It makes sense. Okay, let's get our leader there. What's up, guys? Yeah, that relic is blocked. How do you feel about it? Probably not pretty good. Everything seems pretty good here. I do want to get some Predator tanks out on the field before we decide to go into the power thing. What is it called? Chaos powers? Chaos whatever it's called. Alright, let's move out. Skulls for the Skull Throne. They very rarely say Skulls for the Skull Throne. I'm quite pleased that they said that, because that's my favorite line in this game. Skulls for the Skull Throne. What do the Chaos do? They collect skulls. For what? The Skull Throne? Obviously. Obviously. Oh man, they already have a Cassican squad. Wow. Let's head on over there then, because you know what? They're being a bunch of baddies. Blood! I love them so much. The Khorne Berserkers have to be my favorite. My favorite squad. Alright, you jerk. Why are you... Why? Why do you even? I can't even. Alright, I guess this is a vehicle, because these guys are using... Nope, now they switched over to plasma guns? Yeah, they're using plasma guns, that's kind of... Alright, now those are melta guns. Oh, those could be melta guns, that's probably what they are. Okay, let's head on out, guys. Good job, everyone. Pats on the back for all. Can we auto-reinforce gun... What? You can auto-reinforce your plasma guns? That's interesting. I like that. I can get behind that. Probably want to go for the flame first before we upgrade our heroes, because we don't even have heroes. Unfortunately. Let's get our Chaos Energies out there, get some Chaos Space Marine squads. Might as well max out those when we can. There we go. Get some Defilers on the field here. Do we have Defilers near anywhere cool? No, not really. They're just kind of doing the thing. Everybody's doing the thing. Yeah. Let's get the Mechanized Command destroyed here, so don't have to worry about any sort of Sentinels coming on the map. I think Sentinels, all they have is like a las cannon on the front of them, which is kind of pointless. They're the first vehicle you get, and they're anti-vehicles. I guess in this circumstance, they're useful because they're quick to get, but I don't know, man. I don't see the point. Might as well have anti-infantry at that point. But that's probably what those heavy entrenched things are for, that the Imperial Guard have, the little heavy bolters. And I like how it's just one heavy bolter that the Imperial Guard get, where a Space Marine holds a heavy bolter in his hand. Oh, I know, he holds a bolter in his hand, but whatever. Well, I guess one Space Marine does hold a heavy bolter in his hand, if you think about it, because look here, heavy bolter. What do the Imperial Guards use, which takes them like three people to run one heavy bolter, and they have to entrench themselves in the ground? They need three people for that, just for one heavy bolter. Although technically in this game it's a lot more powerful, and I think in the actual board game it's a lot more powerful too, so I have no idea. It's not holy bolter fire, because it's Imperial Guard. I don't think they have any like holy weaponry, like the Space Marine do. It's interesting. It's interesting and confusing all at the same time as I try and learn what the lore is in this game. It's quite confusing. It makes my brain hurt. There we go. Although, quite a lot of things make my brain hurt. Okay, you guys are on control 1. I think I accidentally made you control 2 as well. I did. Oops. Oh well. I should be able to get last cannons here though. Nice. We got... Guys, everyone just head on up to the top base there. Yes, please. Doing good so far. Head on up here, Mr. Space Marine Squad. You guys can go control 1. We're under attack. Well, screw those guys. No one cares. Alright, let's kill them. Kill them, though. Look how spread out my demons are. There we go. Oh, man. Mowed them down with the Gatling guns. Mowed them down. For the Dark Gods! Alright, nice. I love that it's like auto, you can auto reinforce them with plasma guns. That's cool, I had no idea. It's good when you try that stuff out, because you just learn so much. Might as well get the power fist and a plasma pistol. Give the Khorne guys the auto morale breaking ability, which is super good. I don't typically use it, but it's really good. I just use it whenever they're in combat, and I'm like, oh, might as well use this ability because it's active. Who knew that Khorne's were such mages? where berserkers were such mages. Oh man, I love the Defiler's murder animations. He just like squeezes them in his hands. Oh, run him over too. That was nasty. There we go. That sucks for you. And run into the base, guys. Straight into that base. By the way, I totally forgot to build the HQ. My bad. That is my fault. I am messed up. Also, I think in the last fight that we did, the Blitzkrieg on the Bulwark, I totally forgot to... Oh, what was it? I totally forgot that I killed that heretic. I think I killed the heretic that was building the second HQ, so I don't think that actually got done before we won. But, let's face it, that thing wasn't getting done anyway, because we were going crazy. Like, Bulwark is a one defense area, so it's not going to be too defended. We have a bunch of broken buildings in our main base, and they almost killed us, so it's very close. It was basically a base trade the entire time, because we just let them waltz right into our base. And we had no anti-tanks, and they had a Lehman Russ just run right in. Alright, there you go. That's our defense. Looking pretty good here. Only 26 minutes into this episode. Okay, so let's take a look at some other war gear things that we have. So 5,000 kills. We did get 2,000 kills earlier. And we got 5 defenses. We need to defeat 3 enemies. So I think the only ones we can get now is the 5,000 kills and the defeat 3 enemies. We've only defeated 1, so we got to defeat 2 more. And then the rest is gravy. Oh, yeah! And we'll get the Accursed Crozius, which, oh my god. Okay, that's actually a pretty big buff. If you look at that, so that's gonna be an obvious choice. And then Melter Gun's next, and then Demon Prince is next. Okay, so this here Necron Lord's a little bit angry. He only has 2 Scarab Honor Guard, because that makes sense. Yeah. Doing good. We own basically all of Kronus. Kronus is ours. We could go try and get this Chaos Sorcerer. What is he hiding here? Oh man, a Possessed Champion? That sounds pretty good. Although, this is a very small area. So Blitzkrieg might be really good here. What can we do? What can we do? We could just straight up go fight the Necrons, but I think that's better for... I think like a single episode for a Stronghold fight is usually pretty good, because those take like an hour long, as we have learned. So we could... We could go get the Chaos Sorcerer. We could go get the Necron Lord. What could we do? I say we go get the Chaos Sorcerer first. Oh man, no, no, no. That area is too big. That area is too big and the orcs have so many things. The orcs would probably be the last people that we fight. And how do the freaking Eldar have so much shit? Like, they only have 2 pieces of land, yet they have all these items. The Imperial Guard have 2 guardsmen, which makes no sense either. I don't understand. The Tau have 1 thing. That doesn't make sense either, because they don't own any land. Guys, logic is not a real thing. Alright, we're gonna attack the Necrons here. We'll get a barracks, because that's kind of an obvious choice. We'll get a power node, because I like that, and a couple of turrets, just because I like being safe. And we gross a higher income than what we're spending here on each attack, thanks to Bulwark, so that should be helping us out quite a bit. So we are going to the Van Demar Mountains. That's a cool name. Nice, we got a Defiler, holy shit. He'll probably be really quick to die, but you know what? It'll be worth it. It'll all be worth it in the end. This is a very small area. Let us send a Raptor Champion out to explore the map, because I have no idea where the enemy is. In fact, did I tell a Raptor Champion to go capture something? Oops, that was an accident. And a half. Got a couple of heretics out here, because our heretics are just going to be on listening post duty. That's all they need to do. I love seeing Defilers. Yeah, they're so cool. I don't think he does any extra damage. He's just a Defiler. That's all he is. That's all he's good for. And then probably a couple, like a cultist or two. Got a couple Chaos Marines. We wish to serve, Master. Send out this Raptor. Let's go get him. Go get him checking out the map here. Nice. Okay, so cultist squad. Just go grab this relic point and then gather a bunch of points when you can. So I wonder where the Necron army is. So we're being attacked at the top side of the map. There should be 2 bases. Okay, so we know where they are. That's 1 base. Oh, there's the other base. Okay, so we know where they are. Everyone, come back to base. Come back to base, and we'll assault the southern stronghold. Because the other stronghold's gonna take too long to actually get there. Let's get another Chaos Space Marine squad out. Alright. I think this looks good so far. We probably want to go... we'll build that listening post there. We probably want to get an armory, though. And there we go. Get that nice little armory going on. Send out a heretic. Nice. Good job, guys. You guys did great. You guys did great. And now you guys can just chill in the base for the rest of the game because you got hurt. Alright.
We're here for the Dark Gods.
And that guy's fapping. That's what he's doing. Alright, move out.
On our way!
You get another Chaos Marine squad out because they are pretty cheap. Actually, Chaos Space Marines are very cheap. Okay, move out, guys. Yeah, smashed up. And didn't I tell you to join a squad, sir? Alright, here you go. Look at them, already building a sacrificial circle. Or archive. Forbidden archive, excuse me. Sacrificial circle is, in fact, a Chaos Space Marine building. Alright, let's just kill these Necron Warriors. Yes. Kill. There you go. We just told them how to win. We entered in the win command, I think. Is that what we did? I think that's what we did. We got our cultists moving out here, looking pretty good. Send out our other Chaos Space Marines here. Get them on the auto-reinforce. So right now we're going to be hurting a little bit on requisition. But hopefully we'll be able to handle it later on. Send out this heretic now. We don't have this relic point actually captured, but it's interesting how this game, they actually give both players a relic point right at the start. So they expect people to go into tier 3. Alright. Get this turret nice and destroyed, guys. I thought I told you all to destroy the turrets first. Maybe they built this one last. Alright, now kill the Necron Lord. We'll get some heavy bolters here because why not? They'll help us out. Looks like we're losing a lot of health here on our Khorne Berserker, so he can go head back to base. Good job, sir. You served us well. Chosen Champion, you can go head back to base. Good job, sir. Alright, I'll let him leave before I decide to Well, actually, I can just do this. There you go. Boom. And everyone just go attack the HQ. This is great. I am enjoying this. Now, I guess the biggest battles now are going to be the ones where we actually fight the stronghold, because these are going to be very short, but I don't mind it. Oh, nice job, guys. You know what? You guys have done such a good job. Come join the main forces. Also, they're making another monolith. So, good job killing those flayed ones. Let's move on out. Yes. There you go. Go deal with this nuisance. There you go. Kill it off. We don't want none of that nonsense there. Get a plasma pistol for our champions. Nice. Heal on up, guys. You guys did a great job. Fan-freaking-tastic job, everyone. Probably want to upgrade this when we can, but we do have a lot of things on auto-respawn. There you go. Nice. Interesting thing. This point is captured by the other base. Weird. Very weird. It's weird. Okay. Get a few more heavy bolters out here. Can we upgrade to tier 2, though? I would like to. Oh, all right, come on, before they do the auto build. Okay, we need, well, that's probably not going to happen until we get everything built, but I guess we're capturing this strategic point. All right, that's cool. Good job on the critical location, sirs. Okay, grab the middle one when you're done with that, and then grab the other critical location. Nice. Build these lovely listening posts, get everything prepared. Move on out. And this is the last time I build strategic points. These Chaos guys must be super happy about all these kills going on right now. Like, man, we're just destroying them right now. They got some Necron Warriors moving out with some Scarabs. What if those are their Honor Guard Scarabs? That would be kind of cute. Alright, well, let's keep moving. I think they might come back to base if they see that we're doing a bunch of damage here. They're stealing one of our strategic points. That's fine. That is, in fact, to be expected. Get these flayed ones killed, though, first. That'll be a good target. Shit. I hate the Shroud so much. Whatever, guys. Just keep killing the flayed ones. I'll get the Defiler to work on that turret there. And then go work on the other turret. Well, it sucks to be these guys, these cultists, but really, they're only used for meat shields. Nice. Go for the attack, everyone.
Feast on their flesh.
I am not your bootlick. Oh, man. I would love to meet the voice actors for this game. They're like, oh, yeah, I worked on that game a long time ago. They're like, what's Warhammer? Alright, grab this. Nice. Purge the weak if we can. Build a few more heretics. Why not? Wow, I'm surprised that cultist squad is doing alright. Did you guys kill that Necron Lord? There you go. Kill off this here Goss turret. Which is an anti-tank turret. And what is that? That's a Necron Warrior? Alright, good job, everyone. Go kill that HQ. I guess kill the Wraith. Kill the Wraith while you're at it. Nope, alright. He went invulnerable. Move on out, sirs. Oh, they're attacking me with another turret. What a bunch of butts. Alright, boom. Nope, you guys aren't gonna kill us in time. Sorry. Nice, this is a great game. Great fight. The Necrons have been destroyed. This is a pretty massive force that I built up so quickly. I wish there was a timer somewhere to tell me exactly, you know, how long it takes me to do this. That'd be pretty cool. Oh, there you go. Go attack that, please. They don't deserve to have any buildings. They don't deserve to keep living. And here's hoping that we didn't suffer any sort of casualties on the Honor Guard front. Okay. Do they have any more HQs being built here? Give it a moment. Ah, there it is. Kill that off. It's costing them a lot to do this. They're going to run out of money at some point. I'm going to send this Defiler out, actually. Get out of here. You're being attacked by anti-tanks. Okay, we're good. Ooh, that was good. A strength 8 area taken on. Okay, so if we go back to the Commander tab, we didn't lose anyone. Nice. All right, so now we got this lovely guy. What does it say for him? Honor Guard unit drawn from the Word Bearer's most hideously warped possession or possessed marines. Has powerful melee attacks and wields demonic flames, effective against infantry and heavy infantry. I dig it. I dig it quite a bit. Yes.
Yes.
All right, wow. Strength 9 area over there. Wow. For now, I think I'm going to end it here, guys. Thank you very much for watching. I know there's another half to this turn, but you'll have to find it in the next episode. Because for right now, I'm going to have to make a decision off-camera to see where I want to go attack next. I'm not quite sure if it's going to be the Tau Stronghold, the Orc Stronghold, or the Necron Stronghold. I'm having strong feelings about fighting the Necrons right now, considering they were able to move out so quickly. They seem to be the strongest force next to the Orcs right now. So we're definitely going to see how that's going to work out in the future. Thank you very much, guys, for watching, and I'll see you next time.